Welcome to your quick bite of cloud engineering. I'm Laura, and we're here today to chat about cloud engineering. So what exactly is cloud engineering? Well, it depends on who you ask. If you were to ask someone with, let's say, a certification from a major cloud provider, they'd likely tell you it's all about using tools to keep their systems and services running. If you ask a cloud engineer, they'd likely talk about resource management and metrics, or provisioning and maintaining cloud-based infrastructure. But let's climb a bit higher into the clouds. From a 1,000-foot view, cloud engineering is the idea that we bring standard engineering practices and tools to building, deploying, and managing cloud-based systems, which includes all of the teams touching those systems, from development to quality assurance and testing, to operations, to security, and beyond. That's all well and good, but what does it mean? What are these standard practices and tools? Frankly, it also depends on who you ask. But generally, everyone agrees on practices like using version control to integrate everyone's work together in a controlled fashion with tracked history. We reuse code to avoid repeating ourselves over and over and possibly making avoidable mistakes. We automate work to reduce toil and leave mental space for new ideas. But it's not just standard software engineering practices that we're bringing to our cloud resources. We're bringing overall engineering here too. After all, cloud engineering is about infrastructure as much as it is about software. So what might that be like? Well, let's imagine we're building a bridge. When building a bridge, we don't create new bolts, for example, for every join on the bridge, like they might have done hundreds of years ago. No, instead, today we have standards designed to ensure that every bolt meets those requirements. And that means they will be the same from the gauge of the threads to the deformation properties under load. In the same way, cloud engineers use known patterns on each cloud to build, deploy, and manage their infrastructure from architectural design documents that meet common standards. We need these standard practices and tools because modern cloud-based systems are complex with a scale that's difficult to wrap our minds around. By applying the same principles used everywhere else in engineering, we make it easier for entire companies to use cloud-based systems without necessarily needing hands-on help because we provide reusable components that everyone can learn how to use. We also make it less risky to use cloud-based infrastructure because we can test and verify that infrastructure and use patterns that we know through experience will work under load with common software architectural patterns. We also can better ensure security of that infrastructure through access control and other common repeatable patterns from application security and security engineering. And all of this helps us get our work done faster with less risk and more collaboration across an entire organization. So just like with the bridge, we can get from point A to point B faster without running into the obstacles we're trying to avoid. And just like that bridge, our cloud systems that use these practices are trusted with people's ideas and innovations, getting us all a bit further down the road, safely and securely, especially as we get into the holiday travel season. This has been your quick bite of cloud engineering for this week. If you like this video and want to see more, please do like the video and subscribe to our channel and check out the Quick Bites playlist. Also, if you want to learn about something specific, leave me a note down in the comments, right down there. I do listen to those. I'll be back in just 2 weeks for another quick bite. Take care. Bye.